Que sera, sera, whatever will be, as the song goes. And that's a very old-timey song for me to reference, so, considering. But anyway, yeah, okay, now we can work our way to up here. Anyway, now that that's all done and done with, we can start working our way up the tower, so.
Oh my gosh, I remember this room from that stream I was talking about earlier.
Anyway. Oh, and in the GBA version, you can actually fire silver arrows and they destroy the pots like I just showed there. It's pretty cool. I don't think you could do that in the SNES version, but it's still pretty neat nonetheless.
I haven't played the SNES version in about the same amount of time since I played the GBA version.
Mm-hmm. Oh! Dead plastic. Come on. There we go. Come on, there we go.
You did it!
Just to be on the safe side, I'm gonna go invisible right there. Okay, and boomerang! Oops.
This is where things start getting confusing, and oh my gosh, I think I remember that room's coming up soon, isn't it?
That room? Well, probably. I don't know. Wait a minute. Oh, wait, yes. Push that first. Oop. Okay. Okay, good. So far, so good. Oop. Okay, you know what? Screw it. We're just gonna cut the knot, as they say.
Dude, you have to, since you can't really see what's going on.
Hmm. Touché. Alright. Now, let's be careful. I was gonna just...
You did it! You killed him!
No, I hit the blade trap thing, but whatever.
I was being sarcastic.
Yeah, I know. I was just kind of playing along. That's another thing I do sometimes, is that if someone's being sarcastic to me, I'll just pretend to take them completely seriously, and then after a while, they'll just look at me funny, like, Kev, you know I was kidding, right? And I'm just like, oh, I know you were. I was just playing along. And then they're just like, don't do that!
Yeah, because sometimes feel bad.
Cause, no, it's not that they don't feel that, they just get frustrated because they thought I was actually taking them seriously and they were worried that I would, like, that I wasn't right in the head or something. It was, for example, when I was in high school, this one friend of mine, you know, would tell me these really outrageous things he did, and I knew full well he was just trying to be a braggart and just fucking around with me, and I just kind of played around along like, oh yeah, that's cool, awesome, congratulations and all that. And then after a while he was just like, he started getting worried, like, Kev, you know I was kidding. And I was just like, oh yeah, I know, I was just playing along. He just kind of, and the look on his face was just like, oh, I don't want to be mad with him, but at the same time I'm kind of am. And I'm just like, if you're, and I kind of could see that on his face, and I'm like, dude, if you're mad at me, it's fine. I do this all the time, so don't worry about it. And he's like, oh, okay, good. But he was kind of annoyed with me for doing that to him.
Well, whenever my sarcasm's more on the mean-spirited side, I mean, I get worried if people take it seriously, because it's all for good jokes, and I never do it to be mean. It's all just joking around and just stuff I know wouldn't get people mad.
Yeah, I mean, I try not to make people mad if I can help it, but, you know, sometimes they do. I know, there you are. I knew you were around here somewhere.
The other thing for that is also, like,
there we go. Got
trying to ask follow-up questions and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm. Okay, let's see if I can...
Well, the whole trying to not make people mad, but it's like with pre-established information, things like that.
There we go. I just wanted to make sure I got through there. I might just put this all up in one episode, really, because we're making good time here. Oh.
Good time.
Well, of course I say that now. Now, I'm just going to try to avoid these things. Now, this room over here is totally optional, but I'd like to access it anyway. And this is the only case where you have to do it, is, like...
This is the room.
Dash into that thing, and you just leap up here.
Oh my gosh. Just watch it.
Although the ROM hacks, the ROM hacks of this game, the SNES version anyway, kind of take that and run with it a little bit too, and I think that's a little absurd of them to do, quite frankly.
Well, if Mario World's any indication, I mean, when there's those kind of like tricks that you can do, or the like exploitation things you can do within the game, people just drag it down to like the most common thing ever, despite the fact that it's
invisible coin so much blocks, skill. For instance.
Yeah, or things like catching two items or pixel jumps and
I haven't really played many Mario ROM hacks though, and given that I watched Photon John LP a lot of them, I'm like, you know, he took the bullet. I'm not gonna play any of these. Although I am friends with one of the people who made one of those ROM hacks that he LP'd, the Mario's Wacky Worlds ROM hack. I actually met him through the same person I met Kristen through. So, and that's Giga, who I was talking about earlier.
Oh, cool.
He's a really nice guy.
Right? Well, Wacky Worlds looked like super amazing for what it was.
Oh, definitely. I even told him that. I thought it looked pretty good. I haven't played it myself though. Although he did kind of share with me this one Mario 2 ROM, like the original Mario NES version of Mario 2 ROM hack that he made, where he retooled all the characters to do different things, and it was like, for example, like if you have to press and hold the jump button to make Luigi jump higher, and he's basically kind of almost floating like Princess Peach and stuff. It's really kind of bizarre.
So it's like a revision.
But at the same time, he made Toad like totally worthless. Like his jumping is like pretty much non-existent. He takes one leap and it's just like this little small like leap that's like a little like, you know, like a small leap in the air. So Toad basically kind of is like effectively useless. It was kind of like a trollish hack, really. Although he also hacked it because he knew that some people would probably be have frustration with the game. So he kind of hacked it so the game would start off with 99 lives. So that was kind of a silver lining. But still,
my complaint about the original Mario 2, regular Mario 2, is that not the lives, but the fact they only have like two continues.
Oh yeah, that was kind of ridiculous. Oh joy, the Lanmo was. Now I'm not gonna bother using the ice rod on these guys since I have the Golden Master Sword, so so I don't have to worry about like using a lot of taking a lot of hits. So long as I keep the Whirling Blade at the ready, so
dealing a lot of hits and taking a lot of damage.
Yeah.
No wait.
But when I was in the Desert Palace, I used the ice rod on them because they were weak to the ice rod. So there we go. That was easy.
You can already get the ice rod that early in the game.
Yeah, you can get the ice rod before you get go to the Desert Palace. In fact, Shahazral even says an item that shall aid you is in a cave at the east of Lake Hylia. Go get it, and he's talking about the ice rod.
Huh.
Yeah, and I even showed that off in the LP, and apparently it was like a hint towards an oblique hint towards the fact that you have to use the ice rod to defeat the Lanmolas. Anyway, I'm going to use the Aether Medallion to take care of the whiz robes in the room here. Oh, hang on. And it also reveals the hidden path here, so cool. Good riddance.
They're not whiz robes, they're undead black mages.
Oh my god, you're right, they do kind of look like undead black mages. That's kind of freaky.
Is it like the shadow face? They have the skull face.
Yeah. Alright, get out of here. Oh, that was easy. Of course I say that. Oh boy. Let's see if I get rid of these guys again.
We're not skulls, but like ants or Cthulhus. Nope.
Wait, you mean Cthulhus?
Yeah, Cthulhus.
Oh, okay. Speaking of which, have you ever played Cthulhu Saves the World?
Nope.
It's a really funny indie RPG. It's actually on Steam. I actually have it. It's really funny.
I think the last game I played that could be considered slightly indie was Grow Home.
Oh, never heard of it.
It's actually developed, like, produced by Ubisoft and stuff like that, but it's like a tiny in-house studio.
Whoops.
Oh. And it's made in Unity.
That's cool.
Which, despite being in Unity, it's actually a pretty good game.
I have to check that out then. Basically the plot of Cthulhu Saves the World is that Cthulhu is awakened from like his several millennia long slumber to drive the world mad, and then as he's about to use his magical powers to drive the world mad, dang it, I was gonna... Okay, we'll try that again. But anyway, and at that key moment, this cloaked figure appears out of nowhere and seals his powers away. And you don't know who this figure is throughout the whole game. You just know he seals his powers away. And basically, according to the narrator, in order to get his powers back, he has to become a true hero. And because of the fact that he's Cthulhu, he hears the narrator describing that, so he decides to go on a quest to basically save the world and become a true hero, and so he can get his powers back and drive the world mad. It doesn't take itself too seriously, but it's still really, really funny. And it also has some really nice obscure references to the Cthulhu mythos as well.
I just love fantasy stories that don't take themselves too seriously.
Oh yeah, the Dragon Quest series is like very good at that, I think, in my opinion.
Dragon Quest or
crap. Alright, you know what? Screw it. Let's just... Oh, come on, you little... I never had this much trouble before.
Well, that's because I'm here, and we all know that I have a history of fucking things up for everybody.
Eh, I'll take your word for it. Alright, well, that's my last cure-all mushroom potion. I almost said cure-all mushroom.
No, you did say cure-all mushroom.
I almost said it. I almost said it.
It wasn't a potion.
I guess I've got a little Mario RPG on the brain or something.
Oh, I just borrowed the cartridge from my friend Ben, and I'm surprised how much...
Oops.
I'm surprised I didn't even get far on that game when I had on the Wii Virtual Console.
I was kind of impressed with how well I did in my run of it on my LP, really, because, in fact, when Paige co-commentated with me on that, he was during Booster's Tower, and at one point, it was like that mini-game where you have to chase after them and stuff, and I even admitted in the video that the last time I played the game, I did so poorly I only got, like, one or two flowers, and then while Paige was co-commentating with me, I somehow got 5 flowers. It was like the best time. It was the best time I ever had doing that mini game. It was unreal.
I gotta say, I love the flower system in that game. Like for flower points.
Oh yeah, it's pretty clever. And it kind of encourages you to be a little more conservative with your magic compared to most RPGs.
Well, I mean, I just like it the way it doesn't like. You don't get it from leveling up or anything. You find it on the field, so it just
that's pretty clever. Exploration. Yeah, that's pretty clever too. Oh yes. There
good
we
times.
Go.
The person I was watching did not know you could just leave bombs on the wall.
Yeah. Okay.
I think there's another one later where it's like the same principle with conveyor belts.
Oh yes. Oop. There we go. Easy. Okay, magic. Awesome. That's handy.
It seems kind of funny that me and someone else just bonded over watching someone be bad at Link to the Past.
Well, you know, there are worse things you could bond over, I suppose. Now, I'm going to deliberately drop down here and show off this room here, because it's filled with spikes and whiz robes and all sorts of nastiness.
Well, you found
and plus,
the
I'm,
game
and plus I like
on the controllers.
Really?
There
was a challenge like that at Throne Controllers?
Yeah, Momocon, the panel they did there, that was a challenge, was to fight Moldorm without getting knocked off.
Yeah, I probably fail at that.
Yeah, you just jump down. Oh my gosh.
Well, I was doing it just to fill the map, really. Okay, that was too easy, but then again, I have the Golden Master Sword, so that could be why, but still.
Just remember, Throne Controllers at Momocon was just so amazing seeing it live.
I really wish I could have been there for that. That would have been awesome.
Well, the original panel got cancelled because the convention did not have the proper setup for the projectors.
That sucks.
So it turned into a Q&A session, and I did my usual stream crap posting.
That's cool. Yeah. I'm actually, I don't know if it's gonna happen, but I'm actually thinking, like, after my second anniversary of LP, which is in September, like, seeing if I can ask one of my friends who knows Proton John if I could, like, maybe talk to John or something like that sometime, but when he's not too busy, so. And I heard that he's not going to be that busy around October, so that's not too long after my second anniversary, so. I just figured I've been LPing for 2 years, I could figured I'd maybe try to make friends with some of the more well-known people in the community, you know? I mean, granted, and John sort of knows who I am anyway, because I chat in his streams a bit, and also I've kind of been to Juker's streams a few times, and John's been in a few of those, so he's kind of seen my username around a bit, but still. I don't want to be seen as someone who's trying to become more well-known by becoming friends with someone more well-known. I just want to be friends with someone who happens to be more well-known, you know what I mean?
I was just remembering, like, stuff, like, thinking back in MomoCon, just talking to John, how cool it was to just talk to someone else about video games and, like, click so well with the video games being talked about.
Yeah.
It's just something that rarely happens. Sorry for interrupting.
No, and I'm trying to remember the voice I gave Ganon, because it's been so long since I recorded that part. I think I was going with the kind of Emperor Palpatine type voice. Let me see if I can try to remember how to do that.
Yes. Like that. Do it.
Oh, it's great as you could come all the way here, Link. And while I'm very happy to see you again, you better believe that we will not have a third meeting. Prepare to meet your doom.
Okay, that sounded more like a pirate, but whatever.
Sound like Italian Yoda.
Anyway, that was my kind of, you know, like,
you will be,
you know. Anyway, let's just take care of this guy. Pretty much how you do it is just you reflect his shots back at him like usual, although you can actually reflect the shots of his shadowy selves back at him, so you can do a lot of damage in one go. So he's actually, this boss fight, if you play your cards right, is a lot easier than his original battle. So, like so, see? I can't remember how many hits he takes, though. That's the problem.
He takes several. That's all I know.
Yes. Maybe I'll look it up or something and post it. Oh, yeah. He still does that, though. Hopefully he doesn't do the lightning. That, I hate the lightning attacks there. Annoying. Dagnabbit.
I thought the lightning attacks were really cool, though. Just
they were cool looking, yeah, but they were also a pain in the pain to avoid, really.
Well, what I think about it was, they were capable of making something like that with such, like, a precise... Yeah.
There we go, got him! And, oh my gosh, it was Ganon the whole time! Plot twist.
Doctors hate him. See how this man gained 200 pounds in 5 seconds flat.
Yeah. And now that bat thing just goes meow. And now we're here at the pyramid again, but
thanks to the helpful pelican.
Yeah, or the duck, rather. But anyway, although how he managed to get to the Dark World when you couldn't summon him in the Dark World before is anyone's guess. But anyway, I think that about does it for Ganon's Tower. Next time I'm... The next time on Let's Play The Legend of Zelda Link to the Past,
Dragon Ball Z,
or GBA port, we'll be defeating Ganon,
and or will we?
It'll be the finale, one or the other. I don't know. We'll see. Anyway, and I'll also off screen get a few more cure all potions for the fight, just to be on the safe side. So, until then, this has been Golden Tails Geek. Thank you so much for watching this, and thank you, Matt, for joining me.
You're welcome. Thank you for having me.
No problem. Anyway, keep on gaming, everyone. So long.